Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will see how you can easily replace a robot in your station with another one without recreating the whole program you already did. Let's get started. For this example, let's open 07J replace robot. So this is a small dispensing example. We will see how we can actually do that in module 10, where we talk about advanced robot paths. So here we're just kind of dispensing some sealant or some glue or whatever, which liquid into a groove, just like that. But let's say that we are evaluating if we want to use, I'm going to bring that back. If we want to use an ABB robot, a KUKA robot, a FANUC robot, we don't know yet. So what you can do is right-click the robot and select replace robot. So this will bring up your local library. And if you have robots in your local library, you can select one of those robots and use it as and replace it with the robot you already have in your station. So if you don't have many robots or if you don't have the robots you want in here, your local library, you can just go onto the online library. You select download, it will give you the file and then you drag and drop it here in your local library in the file explorer, so C RoboDK library, and then you'll be able to have access to it. So let's say I'm gonna go and select the KUKA KRC6R900 and click open. Automatically, the robot is replaced, the ABB robot is replaced by the KUKA KR6R900, and if I press dispense here, so there's a small pause here, the path is followed in the exact same way as it was with the other robot. So this way it's super easy to test in between either robot of different brands or with robots of the same brand, but with different, let's say, payload or different reach or different kinematic in general. So that's it. Now I first show you an example that works very well and it's like two clicks and it works. Sometimes it's a bit more complicated than that. So if I right click and I click on replace robot and I select, let's say, a FANUC robot. So let's go for the LRMA200 ID7L, click OK. This may happen. So here you can see that the base of the robot is kind of through the table. This is because by default, when you do that, RoboDK will use the same position as for the base in the 3D environment. But an ABB or a KUKA robot has the base at the physical base of the robot, while a FANUC robot or a Motorman robot has the base along the first axis, the axis of joint 1, and at the height of the axis of joint 2. It means that you need to move the robot up. But in this case, I have the reference frame part, which is a child of the FANUC. So if I was to move that up, the part would also move up, which is not what I'm trying to achieve. So what you can do is right click here, change support, and then you put that part for the moment onto world. So just for the time that we need to move that up here and reach the right height. Perfect. Now you can right click and then change support, FANUC LRMA. Okay, so this was the first thing. There's other things to potentially manage, but it's still a few things that will be fixed in like a few seconds. I'm just gonna remove the pause here, doesn't need it. If I select dispensing here, first of all, weird configuration. Second of all, the pad is kind of at the same height relative to the base as before, instead of being at the right spot with respect to the part. So that's kind of weird, if I can say. This is because sometimes you have here an option when you set the part frame here to force original pause. So this will kind of ignore any modification of the robot, of the reference frame of the part. So if I remove that here, it will go here and run the program. So that fixes one issue. you saw that there was kind of a lot of rotation around the tool to begin with. So that's another thing here. The first motion being a move J, this will kind of dictate which configuration we are using for the rest of the path. So what you can always do if you want is go to home, let's say. You can say, okay, let's rotate that here. I'm going to hide the rod flange, show the tool frame. I'm going to bring that here, just like that, here. I will see here what configuration I have. So here you can see we have, I'm just gonna copy it so this way I can see it later. Snipping tool is always cool to kind of just take a small snip of the joint values. I'm gonna go there. Okay, so that makes sense for me. Right click, teach current position. And now if I go home, I can do that here. I will only have like half a rotation and then the path is launched. So I had to do some small adjustment, but I didn't have to reprogram the whole part or reposition everything around the robot. Everything was done pretty easily in a matter of a few minutes. So that's a very cool way of comparing the result or performance of a station with, let's say, if you are using a UR robot between a UR5 and a UR10, a UR16, which one can I use? Can I use a smaller one or do I absolutely need to go for the bigger one? But you can do that in a matter of minutes instead of having to redo the whole program all over again. So I do think that it's a very cool little feature. So that's pretty much everything for this video and this module. We covered a whole lot of kind of miscellaneous simulation features that are useful for the real integration, not just features that are useful for simulation, let's say, but really features that will help you have a better time integrating the robot and in fact kind of avoiding some mistakes or planning ahead to avoid some unwanted surprise while when the robot is installed on the in the field and at your customer site or in your own plan if you are the end user. So I hope you enjoyed all of that. In the next module, we will talk about flow control statement. So how RoboDK handle if and while statement. And then after this module, so this module will be relatively short, maybe two videos, maybe three maximum. But then the next one is very interesting. In the next one, we will share with you a new feature that we released. At the time this video will come out, it will be released maybe for a few months, but it will be the palletizing plugin. So an easy way of creating a palletizing setup from scratch in minutes instead of hours. So I'm really excited about that. I've worked very hard on this feature. I pretty much took that feature from the ground up with one of my devs, so I kind of managed everything in it, so I'm very excited about it. I play a lot with it and I really want to show you guys what this feature can do. So I hope you will follow along and watch those videos. In any case, have a great day, guys.